Welcome to this latest edition of Union Solidarity International. I'm Andrew Brady, and today I am speaking with our comrade Sudhir Katiyar, who is live from India, who's going to be giving us an update on some of the recent developments of the team's unionisation drive in Hyderabad and Andhra Pradesh in particular, but also Rajasthan. Sudhir, there has been a number of very worrying developments over the last couple of weeks in Hyderabad and Andhra Pradesh. Could you just share with our viewers and listeners exactly what has happened?
Yeah. See, in Hyderabad, the condition of Bitcoin workers, it is, I would say, one of the worst in the country. Workers are from Odisha and they get paid the lowest wages, even amongst Bitcoin workers all over India. So the owners are not happy with our work. Owners have been not happy at all with what we are doing, trying to organize workers, trying to ask for higher wages. What happened on 16th of March was that our team in Hyderabad received a complaint from a particular brickkiln saying that the owners are forcing the workers to work long hours, beating them up, and even threatening them with the pistol. At gunpoint, they are being forced to work. So our team went to inquire into this incident on 16th of March. There were totally six people, and of them two were girls, two were female. And the team, after I spoke to the workers, it recorded their testimonies. The team was surrounded by the owners. The owners called their henchmen from outside. Totally around 50-60 people came. This group surrounded our team from all sides. The male members of the team, they were subjected to severe beating. Their clothes were torn off, and in particular, they directed their anger at the local community mobilizer by the name of Krishna.
Yes.
So they threatened to murder him. They said that if you're seen again, the victims, any victim in the area, will murder you. That is the type of situation that arose in that particular place. A similar incident had taken place in another brickkiln a couple of days back with another NGO, where the people had gone to investigate and similar thing had happened. So basically, it sets a pattern that the owners are not willing to allow outsiders to enter in that area. The sad thing was that the next day when we went to make a complaint to the police commissioner, so when we went to the local police authority, ACP Shamshabad, he, instead of listening to us, he started scolding us. He was very angry with Krishna, and he said that you've been harassing brickkiln owners, you've been asking them for money. So he refused to listen to him. He absolutely refused to listen to him. Even though it was a very major incident of violence, no police complaint was filed, and the team has to come back without filing a police complaint. So since then, we have been undertaking an advocacy campaign. We have written to various statutory bodies. We have written to National Human Rights Commission. We have also started an online campaign on change.org, asking our supporters to write to the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh to, first of all, file a police complaint in this particular incident of violence, also to undertake a general inquiry and ensure that there is no bondage of brickkiln workers. And workers, the wages are increased, wages are hiked to the legal level.
Okay.
Another thing that we have done is that we have got in touch with a member of parliament from Odisha, Mr. Vijayan Panda. Mr. Panda would be visiting this particular brickkiln on 10th of April. Basically, as a fact finding, it's like he would be coming to look first hand into what is the situation at ground. So this is already turning into a fairly high profile visit, because his office is directing to various people, the labor department, the local collector, the police people, and hopefully after the visit, we'll be able to get some movement in the campaign on the ground, in the sense that the police would likely to be reprimanded for this, what they have not done, and the workers would get strengthened, and this issue of wages would come up in a big way. So even though there has been violence, even though there has been pressure on our team, so we are hoping to use this violence, hope this pressure, build a counter pressure, and to bring out the key issues out in front, and to take the movement forward. We've also been in touch with the workers all the time. Workers are supporting us, but the problem is getting in touch with them, getting to the victims where we can talk to them, with them freely. It is also, the volunteers have also held up the union drive, which we would have normally undertaken. Once the union gets rested, we'll undertake a union drive and then start enrolling members. But that process we are not able to begin in Hyderabad yet, because there is various other happenings that are going on.
Okay, so thank you for that response, and I would just like at this point to draw attention to the report which is on USI's website, which goes into greater detail some of the violence that your union organisers have been enduring to try and bring social and economic justice to areas of the brick kiln where really there is no law at all, that even the state and national laws do not apply. And, you know, please pass on to the union organisers the complete and utter solidarity with the union organisers, and that people around the world through USI and their thousands of thousands are looking at what is going on there and are full of admiration. Also, would like to bring attention that the petition that Sudhir has referred to can actually be accessed on USI's website as well, and we would encourage everybody to sign that petition in order to bring justice, because what you're describing, Sudhir, is a situation whereby the police commissioner is completely siding with the employers and is actually, you know, pressurising the union organisers and is not paying attention to the facts that are on the ground. And that is a very, very worrying development, Sudhir, that even the state agencies like the police, who you would think would be neutral, aren't.
Yeah, just
say it. Sudhir, I know that in comparison with Hyderabad and Andhra Pradesh, where there's a number of worrying developments, the work in Rajasthan, where the unionisation drive has been going along far more successfully, the union has been registered there, and hundreds of workers have already been recruited into the union. Do you want to just describe the comparison about the work that is going on in Rajasthan?
Yeah, in Rajasthan also, you know, when we went for the worker stoppage, when we organized a strike in the month of December, there was violence in Rajasthan also. But that violence we were able to tackle, I would say, and we ultimately, at the end of the violence, we finally were able to reach a settlement with the owners. And the settlement resulted into a significant wage hike for the workers, which was a very welcome development. After that, the workers have been working in the kilns.
Yep.
And most of the owners have agreed to hike wages. So I would say it's been much smoother process in Rajasthan compared to what is happening in Andhra Pradesh. We have enrolled almost 500 members so far. We could have enrolled more members, but still, you know, the access to workers in Bhutkins is not easy.
Yes.
So owners are obviously guarding, and they do not want us to go inside the Bhutkins. So, but we'll continue our efforts. We'll also plan to go to the source areas from where workers come, because workers would go back to their homes in the month of May, June.
Yes.
So once they go back in the month of May, June, we plan to go to their homes and organize meetings at their homes itself, and continue the donation drive at their homes. That is the strategy that we plan to adopt. And interestingly, you know, the movement in Bhilwara has also been expanding to other areas. Like, we have got requests from workers in neighboring districts working in brick kilns, come and have meetings with them. So we have had two meetings in the district of Ajmer, which is just neighboring Bhilwara.
Okay.
The workers came together on their own. They invited us. We had two meetings with them. And now we have proposed schedule another meeting on 16th of April, where the owners are also planning to come, and we plan to have a settlement there also, on the lines of Bhilwara. So that's the welcome development, that not only the movement is getting ground in Bhilwara, it's also expanding to neighbouring districts.
Sutia, that's absolutely fantastic to hear, and I think it's really important where you're describing that there's so many difficulties in accessing the workers at the brick kilns, that it's important to organise within the communities and at the source states where the workers are coming from. I think that is a model of union organising that is, you know, absolutely imperative and is an essential part of our strategy, that you can't always do things in the workplace. Sutir, could you just describe how many workers have been the beneficiary of the wage rises in Rajasthan? Are we dealing with thousands of workers?
Yeah, the wage rise in Rajasthan will impact, I would say, at least 10,000 workers.
How many, sorry?
10,000 workers.
10,000 workers. 10,000 workers, that's brilliant. That's brilliant. Sutir, that's absolutely fantastic news, and how the unionisation drive, the union getting registered in Rajasthan, and hundreds have joined the union already, and because of the pressure that you're applying, around about 10,000 workers have been the beneficiary of your efforts, and we hope that in the coming months, that despite the difficulties in Hyderabad and the state of Andhra Pradesh, that similar sort of efforts can come to fruition. It just leaves me, Sutir, to thank you for this latest update. I would encourage everybody who's a follower of USI to check out those articles relating to the violence in Hyderabad and also the petition. And we look forward, Sutir, to speaking with you and a number of the workers on the 16th of April to speak directly to those who are the beneficiaries of your hard labour and efforts and the money that we have been able to raise as a result of our union donation and affiliation strategy. So
yeah, Andrew, thank you. And in the end, I would also like to express our gratitude once again to USI for all the support it has given us. It's not only the financial support that you gave us, but it's also the moral support that we're getting from you. It is very valuable. You know, just knowing that so many people are with you from such a far off place, it also adds to our strength and adds to our efforts. So thank you very much, Andrew.
No, thank you, Sutir. Thanks, my friend.